Hey guys, it's Jessica, and today we are gonna do a new Amazon favorites. I'm so excited. I have collected like 12, 13, 14, something like that, items that I've recently tried from Amazon that I think are amazing, that are worth a look for you guys. It's always a random smattering. I know I do a lot of makeup videos, but this is not a makeup video. This is just like random amazing things that you need in your life, unless you don't, be a smart consumer. But I love Amazon, and so I will have links for all of this. I also do have an Amazon marketplace, which means I have a link you can click below. It'll take you over to Amazon, and it will show you all of my little curated collections of like my favorite skincare that's on Amazon, my favorite clothing items on Amazon, things that I've personally tried and gotten from Amazon that I think are incredible quality, etc. So I have a, if you hear a grunt, it's a pug, it's a pug. So I have recently done this, I think in December, so about 3 or 4 months ago, I did an Amazon favorites video of a whole bunch of other stuff. So I will link that video below, because if you get to the end of this and you're like, I want more Amazon, go watch that one, because that one has like the original favorites. So now I'm like digging deeper, but those are like my original favorites that were like fresh on my mind, like these are the best. So. Okay, first thing, oh my gosh, I get so many questions about these. When I get ready in the morning and I'm doing my makeup, I don't want my, the like foundation or anything to get all in my hair, or even just moisturizer, even if you don't wear makeup. I love wearing like little headbands with bows, and I got this 4-pack of headbands. Let me see the price. Yeah, I got this 4-pack for 10 bucks. So, and I've looked in a lot of like stores in person. I can't find products like this as easily. So they just have this cute little bow. There's actually a little wire inside so you can like form the bow if you want it to stick up more. You know what I mean? So it's really, really cool. It came in a pack with red, black, light pink and blue. When I've worn these a couple of times, you know, I get makeup and skincare on them, I just toss them in the washer and the dryer, no problem. These wash just fine. They're really, really soft. They're really stretchy. I have a big head, you guys. These are not tight on my head. They stay in place, but they're not so tight that it's uncomfortable. I have a few like that and I don't like it. These are incredible. Probably one of my favorites, some of my favorites I've ever owned. So if not, honestly, my favorite, because they're comfy. So highly recommend. I will link these. Okay, next up. Cute mouse pads. Guys, Amazon has so many mouse pads. I'll put a link for this one that I'm currently using. They're very inexpensive. I think this one was $6.99, and I love that in the center it was kind of open, so that's where I sit my wireless mouse. But I thought this was so pretty. And this is one of those things that I'll usually have the same mouse pad for like a year. Then it starts to get dirty and kind of peel up in the corners. And so I buy a new one, which is perfect, because after about a year, I'm kind of tired of looking at this one every single day while I'm working. So that's something, it's just kind of a cheerful way to dress up your desk. Actually, today I'm filming a desk tour of where I work. And I have a lot of cute stuff I bought on Amazon. I'm not mentioning a lot of it here. This is, I think, the only thing, because I figure I'll save it for that video, but definitely stay tuned. And if that's up, I'll link it, because there's a lot of cute desk accessories and really functional stuff too that I bought on Amazon that I'm not gonna mention in this video. Okay. Love this. I love the navy blue. I love the flowers, but they have so many cute things. So definitely check that out. Okay. Pens. Let's talk pens. I mentioned this in a favorites video, but I know not everyone saw that. But this brand of pens, I don't know how it's pronounced, but it's, well, it says Sipa on the actual pen, but on Amazon it says Tao Tree. I will link the exact ones I have. These came in a 10 pack for $5, and these are these 0.38 millimeter pens. They're kind of like I used to use the Papermate Flare pens, where it's kind of that like tip. No, actually it's nothing like that now that I'm thinking about that. But I guess what I'm saying is it's not a rollerball. I usually like pens that write really thick, like those bold, extra bold, like Bic crystal pens. I can link those too, because those are also a favorite you can get on Amazon. They write really, really juicy and fat. These are something in between where I'll kind of push on it a little bit and it kind of makes it write a little bit fatter. And I really like that, because these are still really good and I love all the different colors. I'm gonna have to buy some more soon because I want more colors. And they're so cheap. I think you can get like a 25 pack for like $10. It's insane. So I'm excited to buy some more. And I'm actually just currently, I'll probably put them back in my little holder up there. But I also have this little baggie I got from Target that's really, really cute that can hold them too. Okay, laptop case. I love, this is from the brand Lacto. And this, first of all, I love this color gray juxtaposed with like the fake kind of brown leather. I think that's so pretty. I love this, and I've traveled with it once. I'm gonna be traveling with it again next week because it's a really, really nice, thick inner lining. This feels very reminiscent of like the, what are those beautiful, like really expensive ones you can buy? Anyway, it feels incredibly well made. It's really, really cushioned. So you're really protected in there. The zippers are nice. They don't get caught or anything like that. And they're strong. But what I really love about it is that there's so many pockets. So like I could slide a magazine in there, have my laptop in there. I could have my Kindle in there. I could have my chargers in there. Like there's so many different things. I put all of those things in here when I traveled last time and it wasn't crazy bulky. I mean, it was obviously a little bit thicker once you put all that in here, but it wasn't so bulky that you couldn't zip things or anything. It was amazing. So this is just an incredible, and what I like about it is like this, all most of these pockets actually zip. So I don't feel, you know, I feel like they're all protected. The only one that doesn't zip is this one back here. But again, if I just had a book or a magazine or something back there, I wouldn't really care as much either. Anyway, but that retails for $13.99. It's not even that expensive. I think that is incredible. Okay, and speaking of travel, I bought this before my last trip. It's this beautiful bag. It's canvas, but again, it has this like really pretty fake leather around it. This is a really, really strong bag. Let's see, it retails for $35. I think that's a steal for the amount of space you're getting. I use this for carry-on. So the whole middle portion zips, and then inside of it, there's a zip pocket on one side and two just kind of open pockets. And then what I really loved and found incredibly useful are two other things. First of all, there's another zip pouch back here. So it was nice if I needed something to be able to be grabbed quickly, like my phone or whatever, or my wallet, I could stick it in there and maybe have it up against me. But not only that, there's an opening here. If you have a roller suitcase where you pull the thing up, you can slide this over the handles and it stays on there really, really well. I was so impressed. I've had bags that do that before, but this one seemed to stay on there pretty well. And I liked that there were like the little claws on the bottom. It's comfortable to carry like this. It came with the strap that can go crossbody if you want it. For me, it's a little too big to do that because it ends up just getting heavy, but I loved this. It worked really well. If you're a mom or dad, and you need a bag that you can hold your own stuff in for a carry-on and maybe some baby items, this is it because it's got a lot of space, but it's still carry-on size. And I could fit my laptop and case and everything in here as well. And that, I bought that floral, but they had a lot of patterns. So definitely check that out because if you're not in love with that pattern, they had a lot. They had striped ones that were really, really cute. I think they had plain colored ones too, other floral patterns. Okay, this is a random one, but I bought these on Amazon kind of on a whim, and they're these adorable little pearls that have little cat ears. Isn't that cute? They have different colors. So this is like a white, it's fake pearl, obviously, a white pearl with little like silver ears, but I think they had some that looked more golden, things like that. So these are $15, which it's not like it's a steal. It's not. But it's just one of those random gems I found that I fell in love with. And I've never seen this kind of earring like in Target or anywhere where I could just easily get it for probably under 10. Let me know if you find this kind of earring cheaper, but I really, really like this. They're so, so cute. Before having a baby, I obviously weighed less. And as I've been losing the baby weight, the hardest part for me, or if you're just someone that your weight fluctuates, you know, it doesn't have to be that you had a baby. If you're someone that you feel like your weight fluctuates a lot and you need something that's going to kind of work for different seasons of your life, these are them. So what I love, these are these Daily Ritual jeggings from Amazon. I think they were like 20 bucks. Let me see. Yeah, $20. And they have pockets. So they feel like real pants. The back pockets are real pockets. They're, you know, they feel like denim. They look like denim. The front pockets are not real though. But they have actual belt loops if you wanted to actually put a belt on. But they, you know, are form fitted all the way down, including up at the top. But what I like is these are a little bit more high rise and it has a thicker band here. So it kind of holds the rest in. Does that make sense? But they were surprisingly comfortable. Sometimes with jeans, the knee, my knees really bother me if they're too tight because I feel like I can't bend the knee fully. And so I feel like I'm pulling the pants up to give my, like, give some slack in the knee. I don't need to do that with these. These really do feel comfortable like leggings, but they look like jeans. So I was surprised. This is one, I don't know what size. I can put what size I got down in the description box because I'm sure it's in my order history. But because I cut the tag off. I think the tag like bothered me in the back and I ended up cutting it out. But I could see myself buying another pair of these because I really, really like them. Now, they do have a pair of black ones and I bought those. I think it was in my like Prime Wardrobe video that I did a long time ago trying that out. And in the end, I didn't love them because they had the same waistband, but it was a little bit like They just weren't as comfortable. I can't explain it. It was like the material they made and the waistband would flip down. But I don't have that problem with the jeans. So I don't know what in the world was going on with those black ones. Okay, random favorite. This is this sweater that has like this kind of cowl neck. And I love this thing. So this one is $29.99. It's kind of pricey. But a lot of you guys asked me, like, you know, obviously Amazon sells so many clothing items. Like, which ones are actually nice? Now, the only gripe I have with this is that on the back of the turtleneck, which you never see, there's like this exposed stitching. I don't really know why, but you flip it down, you don't see it at all. Like, it's never been a problem, but I did think, I was like, eh. Here's the thing, you guys. This is the softest kind of swing sweater. Like, again, this is paired wonderfully with leggings because it's just slightly longer. It's not super long, but just slightly longer. It's not going to cover your whole booty though, so if that's what you're wanting, this won't do it. But it's also looser, so if the leggings, you know, when you sit down, you feel a little self-conscious. This, it's just beautiful and comfy, you guys. I'm telling you, this I wore so much. Now, I just looked this up today when I was getting ready for this video and preparing, and they have a mustard-colored one. I'm like, crap. And then I saw they have a really pretty shade of gray. I'm like, no, like now I want all of them, but it's very, very soft. I was surprised at how soft this was. Very, very comfortable. So I totally recommend that. I almost didn't bring it up because we're moving into spring, but I'm like, nah, that sweater is nice. Okay, next is Powder Puffs. I told you guys I would buy from them and let you guys know how they are because I have like an expensive Laura Mercier one. I'm like, why? It's not any better. And actually I think these are softer. So these are from the brand, I think it's Jolie, and you get a 3-pack. The other one is somewhere in my vanity. You get a 3-pack of these for like $4.99. These are incredibly soft. You can literally wash them just with soap and water the way you wash your brushes and let them air dry. I use them for loose powder sometimes to kind of roll it on, but most often I use this to, I have to like kind of pull on my eye a little bit to do like winged liner and just liner in general. But I noticed that when I do it with my fingers, the warmth of my hand melts the foundation and skin. It doesn't melt the skin, calm down. But it melts the makeup underneath it. And so then I lift my hand away and there's like fingerprints. I'm like, ugh. But with this, whether or not there's powder on it or not, it doesn't really matter, but it's not melting anything. So I can do that and then lift it away and nothing is messed up. So that's how I use Powder Puffs more than anything. And these were a great find. So totally recommend. Another favorite, this is a weird one. I heard about this from Samantha Brown, who is like a travel guru. She's got a new show called Places to Love, but she had posted a blog post on Twitter. I follow her, of course. About some of her favorite travel items, and this was on there, and I literally right then went on and ordered it. So it's this humidifier, but it's a travel humidifier, and we did travel with this and it worked wonderfully. So hotel rooms are notoriously dry, but not only that, when you travel, you know, you're in different climates, it's nice to make sure that you have some kind of humidity while you're sleeping. Keep your nasal passages kind of moisturized, all of that. But not only that, but like we have a baby, and when we traveled last, she was getting over a sickness. So we were like, we have to have some kind of a humidifier. Now this is not gonna like fill a whole room with, but it is perfect for what it is. You literally screw this off, you fill it with water. I just dumped out the water that was in it from last night. You fill it with water, you put this right back on. It comes with a little tiny cord that you plug into there, and then it's USB. So you just plug it into a USB charger or like a wall charger. And then you just push the button, you turn it on, and it mists upwards. But not only that, it can have color, so it'll have like a little color come out, or you can have the light off. But I thought that's just like a fun additional thing that you can have like some colored light with it. But the mist is not colored, by the way, it's just there's a light. I wanted to make that clear. But I really like this. They have, I think, not just gray, I think they had colors too. We just went with gray because it was for all of us. But this was such a fun find. How much was this? Yeah, $17.99, a little bit pricey, but figure it's so easy to clean, which I love, you know. It's nothing crazy complicated or complex. But I figure this is something too that I could see me replacing every other year just to be sure that it's nice and clean. You know what I mean? I don't think I'd want to use the same one for like 20 years. That would go for any humidifier. Next is this brush holder. I actually bought this at a store near me called Meijer, but when I was finding links for that stuff, I found that this is sold on Amazon. And not only is this one sold on Amazon, but they have a bunch of really cute versions of this where it's like different sayings, but they're all really, really cutesy like this. So this one says, "Good morning, gorgeous." It's got little lashes, but it's kind of like a ceramic feel, and it's black on the inside. and it's taller, which I kind of like. It holds my brushes in. So these are $12.99, and like I said, there are tons of designs. Really, really cute. It looks so cute over on my vanity right in front of my mirror. It does the job. It can hold enough brushes, but I like that it's kind of limiting me to how many brushes I should have out and dirty at a time. You know what I mean? Speaking of, I keep making eye contact with this giant thing of brushes and sponges that are dirty that need to be cleaned, and I'm just like pretending I don't see it. Like I'm pretending. It's like when you see someone you kind of know at the store and you avoid them and try not to make eye contact so you don't have to talk to them. I know that's terrible, but I know most of you guys do it too. We all do it. This cooler is so cool. So what we loved about it is we needed a new soft-sided cooler. We're going on a really long road trip really soon with my husband and I and our daughter. And so we like to have a little cooler in there with, like, you know, water bottles for me, like LaCroix, and then like snacks, like cheese, and just things that we can kind of quickly snack. And it's nice to keep that kind of stuff cold. And especially now that we have a daughter, you know, there are things like yogurt, things we might be giving her that we do want to be able to keep cold. So it's really nice to have something, but we don't want to bring our giant cooler. It takes up way too much room for what we really need. So we love soft-sided ones, but our last one we had broke. Like it just straight up ripped. So we found this one. And what the reason I love it is I was watching the little video they have on Amazon of this. And if you go to the product landing page, you'll see, you can watch the video. But I love it's like leak proof. But the best part of it is there's this top area that just lifts up. So you can like, I can reach in the back seat, lift that up without having to unzip the whole thing. Cause for me to do that, I'm unbuckling, leaning over, you know, it's super unsafe. But with that, I can just pull up the thing, grab, you know, a water bottle or whatever we need, and then just shut it back down. And it still has the insulated part that goes back into it. So it's a really smart design. I love, again, that kind of gray since we're all using it. We like neutrals for stuff like that. It's just, I like color in other parts of my life, but I like neutrals a lot. Next up is our duvet. We actually use this on our bed, our master bed. It is this white duvet. It's $31.99. You can use it as a comforter on its own if you want to, just straight up. But what we love about it is the weight. It's the perfect weight where it's not super heavy, but it's not crazy light. It's right in between. We've washed it already like two or three times. It washes and dries beautifully. You don't need to air dry it or anything like that. And we use it inside of a duvet cover. We got like a nicer duvet cover, but this cheap duvet is doing a great job. And we love that it's a true duvet, meaning it has little loops at the four corners so that with our duvet cover, we can tie it to that. Because our problem was we were originally using an actual comforter in our duvet cover, and it wasn't really working because it wouldn't stay in place. So I'd be pulling the duvet cover, but the actual duvet would be like a foot down into it. So if you have that problem, if you buy one that's actually marketed as a duvet like this one, there usually are ties in your duvet cover inside where you can tie it to that, and then it kind of keeps the four corners where they are, and in the end, the whole blanket stays where it needs to be. Does that make sense? So honestly, duvets and duvet covers were a very new thing to me when I became an adult and when we got married. Like, I never used those growing up. We just had, you know, our cutesy little comforters growing up. So I didn't even understand what any of that was, but I really like it because then we only need to wash the actual duvet, you know. Honestly, I do like every other month maybe, unless like there was an accident or something. But, and then the duvet cover, of course, I wash way, way, way more often. So like I mentioned earlier, if you are interested in more of my Amazon favorites, lifestyle, everything, I did do one in December. I will link below and up in the cards so that you can check that one out. Other than that, I hope you'll come say hi to me on social media. It is JamBeauty89 everywhere, and I'll catch you guys in my next one. Bye.